हेलो एवरीवन, सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द टॉपिक फ्रॉम एडवांस प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेसेस व्हिच इज द सब्जेक्ट एंड द टॉपिक इज नॉन कन्वेंशनल मशीनिंग प्रोसेसेस। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द मटेरियल रिमूवल प्रोसेसेस आर डिवाइडेड इनटू टू ग्रुप्स। सो दैट आर, one is conventional machining processes and second one is non-conventional machining processes. So first, what is conventional machining processes? So for the removal of excess material from the workpiece, the tools are used which are sharp edge tools, what we can say cutting tools that remove the material from the workpiece with applying some force on that workpiece, and material is removed in the form of chips. Okay, so that process or that machining we can say conventional machining process. Okay, so and what is non-conventional machining process? So obviously it is the opposite of conventional. So in the non-conventional machining process, the material removal from the workpiece, which is take place by some of the techniques like thermal, mechanical, electrochemical. So with the help of thermal, electrical, mechanical, or the combination of these techniques, the material is removed from the workpiece is called as non-conventional machining process. So which are the two machining processes? Are one is conventional and second one is non-conventional machining process. So in non-conventional machining process, the classification is, one is mechanical, okay, which is one technique mechanical. Second one is electrochemical. And the third one is thermal. So with the help of these three techniques, the material is removed from the workpiece, which is called as non-conventional machining process. So first come to the mechanical. So in mechanical, the first one is abrasive jet machining. A J M, abrasive jet machining. Then second one is water jet machining. W J M, water jet machining. Then third one is abrasive water jet machining. A W J M. And then fourth is U S M, ultrasonic machining. So with the help of abrasive particle, with the help of water, with the help of water and abrasive particles, or with the help of ultrasonic waves, what we do, we remove the excess material from the workpiece. So in these cases there is no harder tool or any cutting tool is physically present. These all are the part of the system, like abrasive particles, water, then abrasive water and ultrasonic machining. So with the help of this technique, what we do, we remove the material. Then we come to the electrochemical process. So in physics and chemistry we learn that electrochemical process. So with the help of electrochemical, combination of electrolyte and electricity and combination of electrochemical process, what we do, we remove the material from the workpiece. So which come under, one is electrochemical machining, ECM, electrochemical machining. Second one is electrochemical grinding, ECG. Then third one is electrochemical drilling, ECD. So with the help of electrochemical process, we remove the excess material from the workpiece, we drill or we grind the workpiece. Then the comes to the thermal. So in the thermal there is laser beam machining. Okay, with the help of laser beam we remove the material from the workpiece. Then EDM, electron discharge machining. And third is electron beam machining. So in the thermal, what we do, we focus that laser or electron or electron beam on certain part for a time of interval. The heat is generated and the material is removed from that workpiece. So in non-conventional machining processes, so what is non-conventional machining process? Without any sharp cutting tool, instead of chip formation, material removal process takes place from the workpiece. With the help of these techniques, or the combination of these techniques, mechanical, electrochemical or thermal, which comes under abrasive jet machining, water jet machining, abrasive water jet machining, ultrasonic machining, then electrochemical machining, electrochemical grinding, electrochemical drilling, then laser beam machining, electron discharge machining, electron beam machining. So now first, abrasive jet machining. So if we talk about the abrasive jet machining, AJM, abrasive jet machining. So abrasive means the abrasive particle of in the form of fine grain which are mixed with the air or the compressed gas, and with the high velocity which are fit towards the workpiece, and due to the high impact on that workpiece on some certain area, the heat is generated, or in the form of some crack or fracture, that material is removed from that workpiece. So abrasive water jet machining, let's see, this is a tool of abrasive water jet machining. This is our workpiece. This is our workpiece. This is our nozzle. This is our nozzle. These are the abrasive particles. So these abrasive particles are thrown or fit to the workpiece with high velocity. So it impacts on this workpiece and the material is removed from this workpiece. So this area is removed, this excess material is removed from this workpiece. So, and this is our nozzle. So let's see the systematic diagram of this AJM. So there is one gas cylinder or a compressed gas or a compressor which compressed gas for the process. So first of all, this is our gas cylinder. Okay, so this gas is mixed with a abrasive particle. Okay, so here is our mixture. So this is our mixing chamber. This is our mixing chamber. So gas is traveling through the cylinder, through the pipe, into this mixing chamber. There are some abrasive particles into the gas chamber. So this compressed gas is traveled to this chamber and mixed with this abrasive particle. Okay, so if we are talking about the mechanical systems, we need some control valves, check valves, or flow control. So here are some control valves. Okay, so pressure control valve or the back control valve. Okay, then this mixing chamber is connected or attached with one stirrer to mix gas and abrasive particles homogeneously. So this is a motor operated stirrer which mixes this gas and abrasive particles. Then this these abrasive particles are again travel to this holder and holder is attached with a nozzle. Okay, so this abrasive particle and the gas mix, which is passed through the this nozzle, and here is our workpiece. So again, this material is removed from the workpiece with the help of abrasive jet machining. So in this simple process, what we are doing? We are doing only forcing or feeding the abrasive particle with the gas on the workpiece and the material which is removed from the workpiece. So simple. Then we come to the water jet machining and abrasive water jet machining. So in water jet machining, system is same, our goal is same. That what is our ultimate goal? That remove the excess material from the workpiece. So with the help of water jet, so we forcefully impact that with the impacting the water on the workpiece, the material which is removed from the workpiece. So first of all, we need water. So water jet machining. So first there is one tank. This is our fluid tank. Okay, so this tank stores a fluid or a water or a liquid which we are using in our process to remove excess material from the workpiece. So then for pumping this water, we need a pump. So then we are having a water pump. The tank, fluid tank, is connected with a water pump, and this pump take this water and pump to the accumulator, and the accumulator or the working of accumulator is to store the energy and use that energy for a work done. Okay, so that that pump connected to the accumulator. So this is an accumulator. The tank, fluid tank, water pump, then pumps the water to the accumulator, and again this accumulator is having one nozzle here. Okay, and here we are having the abrasive particle. So these abrasive particles are mixed with the water, and this water and abrasive particles comes along and So this is our again workpiece, and this water and abrasive particle impacting on our workpiece and remove the excess material from the workpiece. So these processes are used for the use for the plastic material or flexible material, so that are not more brittle or strong. So for that material, this water jet machining or abrasive jet machining are used. Okay, so again, so and the construction of this diagram is again up to you. Okay, so you can design your system like a tank, water jet, pump, wall. Okay, so third one is so we cover the water jet machining and abrasive water jet machining. So the third is ultrasonic machining. Okay, UCM, USM, ultrasonic machining. So when the word comes ultrasonic, that means wave or the vibration. Okay, so with the help of vibration and the ultrasonic wave impacting on the workpiece, the heat is generated and the material is removed from the workpiece. Okay, so in USM there is again a simple diagram. There is one workpiece and one ultrasonic tool which is connected with a power system, and it generates the ultrasonic wave impacting on the workpiece and material is removed from the workpiece with the help of ultrasonic machining. So this cone with the help of power, and this generates the ultrasonic wave, then so it according to your workpiece material. So what type of your work your workpiece is having what type of material, so we generate or we supply that much quantity of ultrasonic wave to the for that machining process. Okay, so now we comes to the electrochemical and thermal. So ECM, ECM, electrochemical machining, simple. There is one tank, okay, which is having two electrodes. One is your anode, second one is your cathode, okay, which is supplied by the power, and the connecting medium is your electrolyte. So if both the electrodes are of copper, then this after the supply of the current, this
कॉपर
इज डिस्पैच फ्रॉम दिस इलेक्ट्रोड एनोड एंड अगेन डिपॉजिटेड ऑन दिस कैथोड. सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस केमिकल प्रोसेस द मटेरियल इज रिमूव फ्रॉम दिस वर्कपीस. सो दिस इज अवर वर्कपीस. सो दिस इज द बेसिक आइडिया. ओके, दिस बेसिक आइडिया ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल प्रोसेस. बट इन अ एक्चुअल प्रैक्टिस ऑल इन द इंडस्ट्री व्हाट वी डन देयर, देयर इज वन वर्कपीस.
सो दिस इज अवर वर्कपीस. देयर इज वन टूल.
सो दिस इज अवर वर्कपीस. दिस इज अवर टूल. वी कनेक्ट both with a power supply, okay, and flow the electrolyte between these two. Okay, so electrolyte flows from this workpiece and tool and the material is removed from the workpiece. So this is about the non-conventional machining process, where we see that the conventional machining process, in the conventional machining process we remove excess material from the workpiece with applying the force with the use of sharp cutting tool in the form of chip. And in the non-conventional machining process we use different techniques like thermal, mechanical, electrochemical to remove the excess material from the workpiece from the workpiece. Okay, thank you.